Hello friends, welcome to the lecture series of subject special purpose vehicle. Myself Professor Lau Patel from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, Automobile Engineering Department. So we are in continuing with chapter 2, that is principle and design consideration of special purpose vehicle. And in previous lecture we have studied about lubrication system and final drive. Like there are so many kind of lubrication system that we are using for different activity or special kind of vehicles that we are using. And final drive. So in today's lecture we will see about the main system or the most important system of special purpose vehicle based on its layout and working, that is called steering system. Generally we have several ideas about steering system, like what do you mean by steering system, how steering system can affect my overall vehicle in driving condition or in different driving maneuvers. Also there are different kinds of steering system that we are using nowadays. So for that we have let us begin with the topic that is called steering system. So for steering system we can say that it is a system that has so many components and linkages, like which allow any vehicle to follow the desired course or path. So for that we have such kind of arrangement. From that we can say that our vehicle can be easily moved from one direction to another or left to right. So based on these elements or mechanical components we are able to turn our vehicle left or right. So the most conventional steering arrangement is to turn the front wheel using hand operated steering. So basically for steering system the main input, that is our hand operated steering wheel, which is positioned in the front of the driver via steering column and many universal joints, which may also be a part of collapsible steering design, and that is to allow to deviate somewhat from a straight line. So from the path, like from steering wheel to the final frontal wheels, we have such an arrangement. Like there are several universal joints are there, several linkages, gears are provided to easily turn with the help of human effort or driver's effort. Also other arrangements are sometimes found on different types of vehicles, like for example a tiller or a rear wheel steering. In such special purpose vehicle we have found rear wheel type steering system, because that kind of vehicle that has two desired in such a way that from the help of rear wheel steering it can easily do task and activity as per requirement conveniently. So for that we are using rear wheel steering system. Now tracked wheels such as bulldozers, tank usually employ different differential steering, that is the tracks are made to move at different speeds or even in opposite direction. So for that in general steering system we have seen like a rack and pinion system, like our left wheel and right wheel, that are having a combined system which is connected with the help of rack and pinion. But in tracked wheels like bulldozers and tanks we have different arrangements for individual axles. Like for left axle there is a different arrangement, and for right axle we have different arrangement, so that it can easily change the RPM of left wheel and right wheel. Also it can change the direction of wheels. So for that we have several different kind of steering system that we are using in bulldozers and tanks. Now let us see about the basic types of steering system. Like we have already talked about rack and pinion system, that is very generalized system that can be used in cars. So in the system you will find A to B, that is a rack, and a pinion is provided, and pinion can be rotated with the help of hand operated steering wheel, which is provided in the driver cockpit. And with the help of driver effort the pinion can easily rotate it over the rack and pinion, and by rotating pinion easily we can change the direction of frontal wheel, like to the left direction or to the right direction. So that is a basic type of rack and pinion system. Also you will find hydraulic as well as electrical system in rack and pinion kind of system. Second, that is the recirculating ball type steering system. So these kind of steering system that can be used in different special purpose vehicles like tractors and other vehicles, in which you can find different rods, also recirculating balls that are provided on the section of gears. So from that we can easily say that the rotational motion can be easily converted into the transition motion. So for from the steering system we can easily turn our vehicle. Third type, that is called worm and sector type, in which you will find different worms, and in the worms there are recirculating balls that has been provided. So with the help of driver, we can easily turn the vehicles from left to right or right to left. Now let us see different example of unique steering systems. Like first, that is the crab steering system. So it is a special type of active four-wheel steering system, and it can operate with the help of steering all wheels in same direction and at the same angle. So this is a one type of steering system in which you can see that if I'm going to turn left, the frontal wheels as well as the rear wheels, these four wheels can easily turn in the same direction at a same angle. So this kind of steering, that is called crab steering. Now crab steering, that is used when the vehicle needs to proceed in a straight line but under an angle, like bulldozers and road rollers, they need such kind of requirement to turn at a same angle for frontal wheel as well as the rear wheels. Like when moving loads with a reach truck or during filming with camera dolly, or when the rear wheels may not follow the front wheel tracks, or to reduce the soil compaction when using rolling farm equipment. So basically it is a kind of special purpose steering that can be used for special task also. So here one example of crab steering, like road roller is there, in which you can see that the frontal rollers are at certain angle, and the same angle that can be provided with the help of crab steering for rear rollers. So the path can be easily achievable, so the road smoothness can be easily done equivalently with the help of crab steering. Moving further, let us see about the articulated steering system. So articulated steering is a system by which a vehicle is split into front and rear halves, which are connected by a vertical hinge. So this kind of steering can be used in articulated vehicles, from which we can say that the frontal portion is differently acting and rear portion can be easily differently acting. So for that we have such articulated steering system. So the front and rear halves are connected with one or more hydraulic system. So for that easily operation or less effort, we are using hydraulic cylinders that change the angle between the halves, including the front and rear axle wheels, thus steering the vehicle. Now articulated haulers have very good off-road performance. Vehicle trailer combinations such as semi-trailers, road trains, articulated buses, internal transport trolley, trains, that can be regarded as passively articulated vehicle. So this is one example of articulated vehicle, in which we can see that the frontal portion and rear portion can be act differently with the help of articulated steering. Now let us see the last topic, that is called power steering. We all know about the power steering, that can be easily accessible or available in many cars nowadays, or also in many special purpose vehicle. Like it can easily reduce the effort of driver and helps driver to steer the vehicle by augmenting steering effort, like less effort and needed to turn the steering wheel, makes it easy to turn or any other kind of maneuver. Hydraulic or electric actuators add controller energy to steering mechanism, so that the driver can provide less effort to turn the steered wheels when driving at typical speed, and reduce considerably the physical effect. So it can easily help the driver to turn in different maneuver condition, like high speed, low speed, while the vehicle is at stopping condition or moving slowly. Other power steering system, like off-road steering, we have no direct mechanical connection to the steering linkages, like they require electrical power. So there are several kind of vehicles that are used nowadays which are having electrical power steering system and no mechanical components are required. So constructional vehicles have two part frame with a rugged hinge in the middle. These hinge allow the front and rear axle to become non-parallel to steer the vehicles. Opposing hydraulic cylinders move the hubs of frame relative to each other to steer. So basically it can say that there are two part of frame that required, and with the help of power steering we can easily control the overall vehicle movements. Now let us see about the diagram of power steering, like steering, torque and angle sensor is required, from which the data can be transmitted to the ECU. Also motor is provided for easiness of driver, oil tank is required for the continuously supply of oil, actuators, pressure sensors and solenoid valves are provided. So basically this is a whole system of power steering which can be used in any vehicle, whether it should be car or special purpose vehicle. So that is all about steering system. Thank you.